Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Kunal Keshri, Assistant Professor at G.B. Panch Social Science Institute, Allahabad. Today we will be covering a part of paper on migration and urbanization, a module on sources of migration data. Learning objectives of this module are to understand sources of migration data like census, sample surveys, national population registers, and other sources. As we all know, migration is the third component of demographic change after fertility and mortality. The analysis and measurement of migration finds its use in the preparation of population estimates and projection for a nation or part thereof. However, migration poses challenges for data collection. Unfortunately, globally there is no standard source of internal as well as international migration data. So, it is difficult to make some comparable analysis. Still, census is the largest source of information on internal migration. Migration data can be obtained mainly from three sources. First, census, second, sample surveys, and third, population registers. Learning objective of this lecture will be understood under these data sources. First, census. A census of population is the total process of collecting, compiling, evaluating, analyzing, and publishing demographic, economic, and social data pertaining at a specific time to all persons in a country or in a well delimited part of a country. Census data have been and still are the main sources of information on migration in most countries of the world. And so for India. India has a decadal census. Usual direct questions on migration deal with place of birth, place of last residence, duration of residence in the place of enumeration, place of residence on a specific date before the census. Historically, information on migration has been collected since 1872. Of the various questions asked to obtain direct information on migration, the question on the place of birth is the most widely asked. The United Nations has recommended that this question may be given top priority. In India, up to 1961, census data on migration were obtained through particulars of the birthplace. The scope of collecting information on migration was enlarged by including the rural or urban status of the place of birth and duration of residence at the place of residence in 1961. Since the 1971 census, data is being collected on the basis of place of last usual residence in addition to the question on birthplace. In the 1981 census, in addition to the above question, information was also obtained about the reasons for migration from place of last residence and duration of residence at the place of enumeration. Information on migration was collected on a sample basis. In 2001 census, the rural urban status of place of birth was not collected. Also, the category natural calamities as one of the reasons for migration was excluded and a new reason moved at birth added. There are many questions on migration status asked in Census of India from 1971 to 2011 which are listed in this table. First, birthplace. Place of birth, rural urban status, district, state or country. Second, last residence, place of last residence, rural urban status, district, state or country. Third, reasons for migration, it is also asked for last residence. Fourth, duration of residence in the village or town of enumeration. In the census of 2011, there were 7 questions on the reasons of migration. First one, work or employment. Second, business. Third, education. Fourth, marriage. Fifth, moved after birth. Sixth, moved with household. And seventh, any other. In censuses, immigrants are also enumerated, but the Indian census, being de facto, does not provide information on the emigration of Indians. It is consequently not possible to study net international migration from census data. Though net interstate migration in India can be examined easily, migrants based on the place of birth. If the place of birth is different from place of enumeration, a person is defined as migrant according to place of birth. On the other hand, if both are same, then person is defined as non-migrant. It is easy to determine the migration or non-migrant status of a person if the place of birth is known. But if a person migrates from her place of birth and returns at the time of census enumeration, the place of birth and place of enumeration will be same. As a result, the person will not be termed as migrant. Thus, based on the question of place of birth, we are not able to capture the return migration. This kind of return migration can be captured using place of last residence data. Migrant based on the place of last residence. If the place of last residence is different from place of enumeration, a person is defined as migrant according to place of last residence. Otherwise, person will be non-migrant. It is the most commonly used measure to determine the migration status. If the place of last residence will be different from the place of enumeration, the actual place of last residence is recorded. Indian census does not specify any duration of stay for considering place of last residence. The census instructions say that the circumstances of each case would have to be taken into consideration before deciding a person's last residence status. For example, temporary movements of a woman moving into hospital for delivery at a place other than her usual residence will not be considered as the place of last residence. On the other hand, in case of the child born to that woman in the hospital, the place where hospital is located will be judged as the place of last residence for the child as per census guidelines. Coming to surveys, periodic sample surveys in many countries provide direct information on migration. The potential uses of sample surveys for migration statistics are enormous. Emphasis in such surveys has been placed on offering the detailed information on the process, causes, and consequences of migration that is usually not available in national censuses. These migration surveys have very specific objectives and cover a part of the study area. There are very few sample surveys which collect national level data on migration in India. The survey carried on by the Indian National Sample Survey Office, that is NSSO, is one and the most important of them, which collects migration data on regular basis. Various national level socioeconomic surveys conducted by the National Sample Survey Office are also the important sources of migration data. The National Sample Survey is a nationally representative, large scale and multi-round survey which provides migration information. It collects socioeconomic information annually and data on migration in India as part of its employment and unemployment schedule every 6 to 7 years. To assess the volume and structure of migration in India, NSSO, starting with the ninth round in 1955, conducted a number of surveys to collect data on migration as part of its employment and unemployment inquiries. In the 9th, 11th and 12th rounds of survey, migration particulars were collected for the labor force population only. From the 13th round of 1957 and 58 onwards, more detailed information on migration has been collected. In the 18th round, survey on migration was conducted on a much larger scale. In the NSS 28th round, which was conducted in 1973 to 74, survey on birth, death, morbidity and disability, migration particulars of the usual members of the sample household were also collected. In the 38th round, collection of migration data was integrated with the regular quinquennial survey on employment and unemployment. The same approach was followed during the 43rd round of survey. Data on migration was collected during the 49th round of survey through the Schedule 1.2. The most recent available migration data from this survey comes from NSS 64th round 2007-2008. In the NSS 64th round, information on migration particulars was collected for each member of the sample households through the employment and unemployment schedule, Schedule 10.2. Detailed information on the migration was collected, particularly period elapsed since leaving the last usual residence, that is UPR, location of last UPR, and whether he or she is a returned migrant and the reason for migration. These questions were asked to the head of the household. Usual place of residence of a person was defined as a place, village or town where the person had stayed continuously for a period of at least 6 months or more. The last place of usual residence was defined as a place, village or town where the migrant had stayed continuously for a period of 6 months or more before moving to the place of enumeration. If the place of enumeration was different from the last usual place of residence, then the person was termed a migrant, whether it's permanent or semi-permanent migrant. Notably, this survey asked a detailed information on the reasons for leaving UPR to the respondents, which is evident from the questions like in search of employment, in search of better employment, business, take up employment or better employment, transfer of service contract, proximity to place of work, studies, natural disasters, maybe drought, flood, tsunami, etc. Social or political problems like riots, terrorism, political refugee, bad law and order, etc. Displacement by development project, acquisition of own house or flat, housing problem, healthcare, post-retirement, marriage, migration of parent or earning member of the family, and other reasons. Questions regarding the temporary labor migration of people were asked. Information was collected for the temporary labor migrants with the help of following questions. A. Whether any household member stayed away from the village or town for 30 days or more, but less than 6 months during the last 365 days for employment or in search of employment. B. Number of spells, that means a period of staying away from the village or town for a period of 15 days or more was termed as a spell. C. Destination during longest spell, same district, that may be rural or urban, same state but another district, rural or urban, another state, rural or urban, another country. In addition to this, this round of NSS provides information on emigration also. An emigrant is defined in the survey as a former member of a household who left the household any time in the past for staying outside India, provided she was alive on the date of survey. Along with information on emigration, questions were asked about years lived in destination, reasons for emigration, engagement in economic activity and remittances, etc. Other important source of data is population register. The practice of recording changes of residence exists in some countries like Sweden and Norway. Such population registration system is potentially an excellent source of data for a study of migration when detailed record of population movements are maintained for the whole country. However, at present, very countries maintain or publish such population registers. The potential importance of such registers in future is immense. These data provide direct information on migration and migrants. Other sources. Apart from aforementioned sources, migration data related to emigration and remittances are now collected through some other sources, which are as follows. First one is Bureau of Migration. It works under Ministry of Home Affairs. It collects information on Indians leaving the country and foreigners entering India from exit points, including all airports. However, Bureau does not publish any data on the outflow of immigrants from India. Other sources: Protector General of Immigrants and Ministry of Overseas Indian Affairs. It publishes annual data on labor outflows whose employment was cleared by the Office of the Protector General of Immigrants. Those who obtained immigration clearance required passports, leaving to work in ECR countries, have to obtain a document to leave the country. Remittances data can be obtained from the following sources. First, reporting by bank or authorized dealers under the International Transaction Reporting System. Second, survey on small value transaction on receipts. Third, funds locally withdrawn from the rupee denominated deposits for various purposes by persons authorized by non-resident Indians. Fourth, information available on inflows on private foreign donations. So far, we have learned about different sources of data like census, sample surveys, and population registers. There are also some other sources which give some information on immigration and remittances. Questions: what are the sources of migration data? Why Indian Census does not collect migration on immigration? Third, define usual place of residence. What is the importance of this information in migration research? Thanks, students.